Welcome back to PC1. Ahead of the upcoming AMA, we're going to give you a short video update on the progress and timelines of the GT50 programme and the HX50 programme. By Friday of this week, we'll have 50% of the prototype GT50 engine on the test bench. This includes the starter generator system, the power management system, the engine drivetrain, and its lubrication system. Our fuel spray nozzles and the ignition system are also imminent, and they'll be tested immediately as soon as they become available. Our plan called for the engine manufacturing to be done in two waves, with two of the four engine modules to be released early, allowing for the engine core modules to be finalised and released. The plan was to finalise the last few details of the engine core during the first quarter of this year, allowing us to manufacture the components and then do the tentative first run of the whole GT50 prototype by the end of this month. Of course, life in engineering and complex product development seldom goes entirely to plan. And one of the areas, really the only area, that's taken a little bit longer than we expected to get just right has been the secondary air system. The secondary air system is crucial as it supplies pressurized air from the compressor around the engine to pressurize the labyrinth seals to ensure that we can keep lubricating oil where it's supposed to be, to pressurize piston faces on the discs and the compressor to balance the axial load on the bearings, and of course, to supply a stream of cooling air to protect the mechanical integrity of the critical rotating components. While the secondary air system comprises relatively simple geometry, such as labyrinth fins, holes, calibrated passageways, and then controlled gaps and seals between adjacent components, the challenge from an engineering development perspective is those features are everywhere in the engine core. We literally pump this compressed air everywhere throughout the engine. And if the secondary air system doesn't work properly, the engine doesn't work properly. You will have performance losses, you'll have shorter bearing life, you'll have oil leaks, and you'll have degradation of part life, none of which we can accept, even on the prototype engine, because it would be really difficult to fix that on a bench. It's much better to deal with these problems at source. So until these key details that were impacting the secondary air system were chased through for each affected part and then validated for each of those parts across the operating range for the engine, we've had to hold off from releasing the engine core modules to manufacturing. And what we first hoped we could resolve in a few weeks has become a few months. And that initially narrowed and has now closed the opportunity for us to manufacture these components in time for the June deadline. The main practical challenge that any engine developer faces on the core of the engine is because the core is so tightly integrated, all of the components have multiple interfaces with lots of components around them, meaning that a seemingly trivial change on one part often affects its neighbours, and its neighbors' neighbors by inference. And so that makes making these design changes extremely laborious. And then on top of that, once you've made the design changes, you then have to repeat the analysis to validate the performance of the secondary air system, to validate the temperature distributions that that then causes around the engine, and then to repeat the strength and the vibration calculations to make sure that the engine is still operating robustly across the range of design conditions that it needs to. We've recently completed everything that we can practically do on the core of the engine, and both the secondary air system and the engine as a whole is working robustly across its operating range. The final two modules of GT50 are ready. We're now releasing and building those two modules as fast as is humanly possible. Our manufacturing team have done an amazing job in using the time to make sure they're ready to receive these components. They've done as much prototype and process development as they possibly can on earlier versions of these components, since they've only changed a little bit. And that means that they've got all of as much of the tooling on hand, as much of the materials on hand, as much of the detailed know-how as to how to make each of these components ready so that they can work through this as fast as is humanly possible. All of this work, including the testing on the first half of the GT50 engine prototype, and everything that's going on across the HX50 program will be the subject of the next AMA, which we're going to hold on the 24th of July. As a result of the additional work, we've adjusted the program milestones as follows to reflect our current position. We're going to do the next AMA on Wednesday, the 24th of July at 1700 hours UK time. The new target run for the full engine is Friday, the 19th of December, 2025. We're going to do the engine event at PC1 on Thursday, the 26th of March, 2026. And the target first date for the first flight of HX50 is Friday, the 26th of June, 2026. And then that pushes target production start date to Monday, the 28th of June, 2027. Well, no one in our community, either a member of the team or any of the customers, want the development to take more than a day longer than it needs to. The simple reality is complex engineering programs have a significant amount of technical uncertainty in them, and you can only deal with that when it comes into focus. Think of it like trying to plan a cross-country flight in the winter, months in advance. Yeah, you can plan it, but it's not until the day comes and you know what the weather really is that you can make your decisions as to what you can do. And at that point, you just have to react accordingly. That's exactly what we're doing in terms of this phase of the engineering program. Over the last few months, our amazing team has built and tested the very first GT50 starter generator system. Built and tested the first GT50 power management system. Developed the first GT50 fuel spray nozzles. Developed and commissioned the production and testing capability for production fuel spray nozzles. Built and tested the GT50 drivetrain lubrication system. Built the first GT50 engine drivetrain and its test system. Manufactured the first full set of turbine blades for the prototype GT50. Completed the manufacture of the first Hill high-speed bearings for GT50 that are now ready for test. Manufactured cast nozzle guide vanes, bearing housings, turbine blades, fuel manifolds, and much more. We'll feature all of this and more in the upcoming AMA on the 24th of July. I'd like to finish by saying thank you to our amazing team. Those of us that work here at Hill, developing, manufacturing, and testing these amazing products, and those of you that believed in us and gave us the opportunity to develop these products for you. Our community. Without the combined efforts of this amazing group of people, none of this would have been possible. Thank you.